Good afternoon. Today is 10th of December. We are starting a discussion on Matplotlib. Last day, I have already discussed in Matplotlib, and Matplotlib, all the necessary tutorials in the YouTube link, you will get it. Okay, so let's get back. Who is the inventor of Matplotlib? He is not an engineer, he's a doctor. He's a neurosurgeon. His name is John Hunter. In 2008 to 2012, he was involved with Matplotlib, and he single-handedly developed Matplotlib. The reason is Matplotlib is that he's a doctor, and a lot of EEG, echocardiogram, and the nerve graph has to be plotted on the computer. And at that time, the visualization software is there in the MATLAB, which developed by a few scientists from MIT. MATLAB still is very popular, but MATLAB is a proprietary software. There's a dongle, and that dongle has to be attached to a particular PC at the back end or a laptop so that the software would work. The software would first check the dongle portion, but he doesn't like it. He wants lots of researcher doctors are there, so he wants an open source free software which has the features like MATLAB visualization from MATLAB. So he's singular, he's a doctor, so he knows the thing. And this is the first graph. This is the nerve endings output. He plotted to that time the Matplotlib. This is all the outputs of the various ECG, ECG echocardiogram, or ECOG is basically another diagram. So he developed it. Unfortunately, he has died of cancer 2012, but he's a very famous person, Matplotlib. Nowadays, another visualization software is there, but Matplotlib, you please study. If you any time in the between, if you have any question, that you can ask me. Yesterday, I've also discussed, but you should see it, the Python. We are discussing the Python in here. Now, this Python is hardly usable. So until and unless you import NumPy into it. So this is a NumPy. So what is the strength of the NumPy? NumPy is a contiguous memory allocation allocated for anything. It can be in integer 8-bit, signed, unsigned, 16-bit, signed, unsigned, 64-bit, 124-bit, 128-bit, like this. And this character, Boolean, anything. You can create any contiguous memory location in memory. That is not available in C also. It's kind of a C, last year discussed, but the C doesn't have so much variety of space. NumPy is very, and NumPy is written in C++. That is pretty fast. So don't ever use any array features of list. The Python list is very slower. So always import NumPy. NumPy written in C++, and it is pretty fast. This NumPy, whenever it is available in Python, then it is a usable thing. Then that comes in SciPy. What is SciPy? Basically, NumPy, you only numeric computation like median, mode, that part, or sorting are there. But if you want to do any cube root or any solution of a algebra or polynomial root calculation, or if you want to an eigenfunction, eigenvector, if you want to with breadth first search, any kind of algorithm searching and all these things, like if you want to make any root, I've said any cubic root, a polynomial root, eigenvalue, eigenvector, Dijkstra shortest path. This is called all basically part of linear algebra. I think you have already started some linear algebra course in your mathematics. So all the formulas are there in the SciPy. So you just have to you have to write it, the import SciPy. Okay, just the import NumPy. SciPy is built on NumPy. Okay. That is, it comes the Matplotlib. Matplotlib is a graphical user interface. Earlier, it was TCLTK and all that, but after this, John Hunter developed this Matplotlib, that is a de facto standard. So it's all included thing. And whatever I have told, that is called Pandas. Pandas is same like Mandai, is a more powerful than NumPy, but it is also, Pandas is also there. So Pandas, advantage of Pandas is you have a columnar feature, multiple column feature and all, you can slice it column wise and all these things, is more powerful than NumPy. But anyway, Pandas is also built on NumPy. Then comes the pie plot, that is another pie lab. These are the more, there are other softwares are there. There you can have machine learning features and all these things. Anyway, so we have already covered NumPy. Today we wish to cover SciPy today. Okay, let's go to the SciPy. This is the features I have already told right now. Why SciPy? SciPy for your linear algebra solution. That's simple. NumPy only give the minimum, maximum sorting. That's all. Any arrays, but it gives a lot of things. So this is the same thing as import SciPy. And I always request you to always, whenever you are importing something, you must check it what version this is. Okay. And you know, these are internal variable __version__. So if you run it and you get it 1.414. Okay. And I'll suggest you to practice all the codes in Google Colab. So you don't have to import on your raw machine. Everything is available in Colab. I found it, everything is available. So it is great. And I have already given these things. This link is already, I have taken it from this link. So these links at my YouTube site, it will be there. You follow these links and you'll get this code. Okay. And also I am already giving another note to it. But you'll get all this link to at YouTube. Okay. This is a SciPy. Then we go for, and this is the SciPy, there are some constants. Okay. So these are the constants. So the liter constant, you know, liter constants, how many centimeter, how many meters are there? 1 liter, it is mentioned there, application. How many cubic meters in 1 liter? How many cubic meters in 1 liter? These are the constant already defined in the SciPy constant, and it will give 0.001. We'll see it. It is very simple. We can see it here. Say, these are the constant, like here, maybe pi will be there, is a constant, a gram, metric ton, grain, pound, what is the, these, all these things are there. If you just run it, you'll get this. Okay, carat, atomic mass, e^-27, sometimes weight of electrons and all these things, mu, all the scientific terms are there. Okay, so it is already defined in the constant folder. This is not very angles, all angles in radians and all these things are there. So if you just run it, see all are there, constant, degree. These codes are already there. Let's see some interesting thing. Time is also there. How many minutes and all these things. This is, you can understand. Great. Let's see some interesting thing which you can appreciate. Hope so. This one, the various pressure. All scientific, take it granted, all engineering thing is there. So root of this equation, x plus cos x, okay? So you have to import SciPy, optimize import root. There's a function root, it is SciPy optimize, and import math, import cos, because this is a cos function is used. And don't always, in Python, don't always import star. Do not go for import. Whatever you're importing, you refer this import cos, import root. So I am importing that only. Okay. So this is the definition of equation, return x plus cos x, my root equal to root equation this, print my root. And if you want to more details, print my root. If you run this, you'll get this, the root of the function is this. This is the root of the function in radian, and all other necessary details are there. Okay, this is very, you just try Python in your linear algebra course. So you get all the functions there, any root, cubic root and anything. So here we are doing it, x plus cos x. So this is important. I think it should be visible. Should I make it more smaller so that you can visit it? I think I should make it a little bit smaller. Let's see. So this is the function. So the root is already I'm getting from SciPy, and cos x is SciPy. I import root, import cos, and then this is the function. So I wish to calculate the root of it. So the my root equal to this, and if we go for I want to know every other details of the function, then I'll get the necessary thing. So this is my root actually, and whenever you print my root, all the things it will be, solution is converged or not converged, everything is given. Like all the numerical solution is library is there, okay, for any any algebraic calculation. Is this okay? Is this understandable? This is interesting. Yes, you can use, you should use it in your maths thing. It will, everything is there. Anyone please respond? Is the, have you understood or not? Codes is there. Yeah. There another is minimizing a function, high point, low point, minima, maxima calculation. This is also sci-fi optimize, import, minimize. This is also is there. This is also optimally minimized. This is automatically the print minima function 1.7. How it is calculated, everything is there. Okay. I optimize in some other language. Remember, in probably some of you covered in Java, import star never use. You always write the library from sci-fi optimize. You just import that particular function and use the function. Okay. So that's it. So this is, you are getting the minimization function same way sparse matrix, sparse matrix also we have this data, okay. And then is a called, there is another interesting thing is sci-fi graph. You can get adjacency list, all these things like your data structure program, your adjacency list, everything is the Jeister's algorithm, shortest path is there. So I'm not going into detail. Everything is available in this link. The link is available to you. Let's get back to the PPT once more again. So what I just tried to, what we have covered today and last class, the basic, not bare Python is hardly usable thing. Whenever you add NumPy into it, that is a real strength. Then if you NumPy give only large chunks of arrays of similar type of say data, maybe character or integer, so you can put it one place to another, but you can make it maximum sorting, maximum minimum. But if you want to make it real scientific calculation, like root of a calculation, maxima minima, all Bessel function, Fourier transform, whatever function you have on the differential calculus. So all this there is in built in the SciPy, so it is really powerful, and we should have a small project on SciPy also to be given to you. And Matplotlib is the graphical user interface. Another graphical user interface, Seaborn, but Matplotlib is historically very significant because it is compatible with MATLAB. This MATLAB is a very proprietary software, still the number one software. This is it. So. These are the all types of various ways, histograms, line chart, bar chart, pie chart, 3D chart, heat map, all these things are available with the Matplotlib. So you please, I have already sent the code in my YouTube link. Now this is, I already covered, the Seaborn is another utility, you can take it. So today I wish to end because any questions I can take right now. Yeah, any questions? Please, one or two questions. Who are you? Anybody? How many? Ask any questions. Srijita is there? Shubham there? Shomolina there? Ask question, please. Yeah, I am ending my presentation. Tandima and others. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.